So starting off with surfing in the morning, we're going to start down in Cornwall. Due to the lack of any low pressure systems off the south coast of England, we have quite light winds on the Cornish coast, as well as quite low swell conditions, as we can see from this map here. We've got between 0 and 2 foot of swell throughout the morning, so it would be best for your beginners. Moving up throughout the country towards Yorkshire area and Sunderland on the east coast of England, we have slightly larger swell conditions of between 3 to 4 foot swell, with light winds again due to the high pressure system there. And further north towards Scotland, we're going to start seeing larger swell, with it ranging between 6 to 8 foot and slowly increasing throughout the day as the low pressure system to the north of Scotland moves down. Towards the afternoon, back down in Cornwall, we're still seeing very little swell, with it being a max still of 2 foot. The light winds are going to continue on through the day. It's a nice high pressure system, so we're going to probably have nice clear skies and very little in the way of cloud. As we move further up in towards Yorkshire, we've got slightly more swell picking up with a range of between 4 and 5 foot, and still fairly light winds with the wind direction moving round to being an offshore westerly wind. Further up in Scotland, we get stronger winds picking up throughout the afternoon with a cold front moving in, bringing with it the possibility of some wet, rainy weather and slightly stronger winds. The swell conditions are picking up to 8 and 9 foot with an increase as that low pressure system moves down on Scotland. The evening, still very little swell conditions in Cornwall, still best suited for your beginners. Yorkshire, we're getting slightly stronger winds now as that low pressure system to the north of the country moves down, and we're going to have swell dropping off a little bit back down to sort of 3 to 4 foot range. And as we move further north, still into Scotland onto the north coast, we're going to get a massive increase in waves with max heights of between 9 and 10 foot. Throughout the day, the best locations for surfing for beginners would probably be down towards the Cornwall area due to the low swell signs. Moving up towards intermediate, up on the Yorkshire coast, and then finally advanced / expert up on Scotland with the very large swell sizes. Moving on to weather forecast for windsurfers. In the morning, starting down in Cornwall, we're going to have light winds due to the high pressure system over Cornwall, with wind speeds of between 4 to 8 knots on the north coast and on the south coast, as we can see from the wind chart in the bottom right hand corner. North to Yorkshire, this morning we're going to have 3 to 4 foot swell, which might make it a little bit harder for windsurfers to participate. We're going to have a much stronger wind between 8 to 12 knots, which should make it suitable for freestyle windsurfers. Up towards Scotland, it's becoming less suitable for windsurfers due to the large swell size. We've got 6 to 8 foot swell in the morning, but we have got very strong winds of between 14 and 18 knots. However, if you're going to windsurf in Scotland, your best bet would probably be to go on one of the locks, because the water is going to be a lot flatter and will be best for planing and slalom practice. As we move on into the afternoon, we're going to see a drop off in the wind speed down in Cornwall, especially on the south coast. We're going to have speeds of 4 to 6 knots on the south coast, making it a little bit too light for even beginners to get out on the water. It's also going to be an offshore wind. However, on the north coast of Cornwall, we've got the wind speeds picking up to 8 knots. Moving further north, up to Yorkshire, we've got a slight drop off in the wind speed. However, as we get further north towards Scotland, there's a light increase up to a max of about 14-15 knots. We're still going to have a large swell, therefore it's best for the freestyle. Scotland is very much the same as this morning, with wind speeds picking up due to the low pressure system moving south down towards the top of Scotland. Moving on into the evening, down in Cornwall, we're going to have much lighter winds now, with a very high pressure system moving over the top of us, so we're going to only have wind speeds of around 4 knots. Yorkshire, it's going to be very much the same as this afternoon, with wind speeds dropping off a tiny bit down to 8 to 12 knots, but the swell size will still be the same. Scotland, wind speeds are picking up even higher, as we can see from the wind chart in the bottom corner, with average speeds of around 16 knots, with the possibility of moving up to 20 as we progress later into the evening. Your best places to windsurf as a beginner would be down in the Falmouth region of Cornwall in the morning, and as we move into the afternoon would be up towards Newquay. Yorkshire throughout the day is good for freestyle windsurfing, and Scotland, unless you're out on the locks windsurfing, is a no-go area. And finally, the weather forecast for the scuba divers. Starting off in Cornwall in the morning, we're going to have temperatures of around 9 degrees on land, and the sea temperatures between 9 and 10 degrees, so make sure you're wearing appropriate gear for conditions. There's little to no swell in the Cornwall region, with a max swell height of 1 foot in the morning. Moving north towards Yorkshire, so we're going to see another cold start to the morning, temperatures between 7 and 8 degrees, matching sea temperatures of 7 to 8 degrees, but with 3 to 4 foot swell. This may make it unsuitable for most divers due to the turbulence that this will cause whilst you're in the water. There's also a stronger offshore wind of around 10 to 16 knots, with a low tide in the morning at around 9:15. The best time to go for a dive in Yorkshire and Cornwall would be between 9 and 10 o'clock in the morning, just after low tide. Moving up into Scotland, it's unadvisable to go for a dive in sea due to large swell sizes of 6 to 8 foot. However, diving in the locks would be perfectly suitable. Moving on into the afternoon down in Cornwall, we're going to experience a slight increase in the temperature. We're going to still have nice clear skies and light winds due to this lovely high pressure system below us moving towards the east. We're still going to have 1 to 1.5 foot swell sizes throughout the afternoon, making shore dives easily accessible throughout Cornwall. With high tide being at 15:20, best time to go for an afternoon dive would be between 1 and 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So it's when surfacing coming back to shore, we're going to have to fight against the tide. As we move further north towards the Yorkshire Scarborough area, we're still going to have the large swell conditions and the fairly strong offshore winds. However, if you enjoy diving in turbulent waters, your best time for a dive here would be between 1 and 2 p.m. With high tide being at 2:21. Scotland is very much the same as this morning, with very large swell conditions. However, the locks are still a viable option. As we move on into the evening on Sunday night, we're going to have a lovely clear evening over Cornwall, with a minor drop in the temperature. Swell conditions remain the same as that rest of the day, of 1 to 2 foot, and low tide tonight is at 9:39 p.m. Moving up towards Yorkshire, we're going to have conditions that are roughly the same as the rest of the day, with still quite large swell conditions of 3 to 4 foot and still offshore winds of 10 to 12 knots, with low tide also being around 9:20 in the evening, with same times as Cornwall for your best dive times, so between 7:30 and 8 o'clock. Your best places for scuba diving would be down in Cornwall, with good visibility due to the high pressure system that's been with us over the past few days. Moving up towards Yorkshire, it's getting a little bit more choppy. You're less likely to want to go for a dive unless you enjoy diving in turbulent waters. Scotland, unless you're diving in locks, is probably not a good idea.